So now we'll see what is shifting dullness test and how it is performed. So shifting dullness test is a test which is done to detect the ascites or fluid in the peritoneal cavity. So let us see how to do the shifting dullness test. Come to our subject and focus on the abdomen. So what should be the prerequisites? Your patient should lie supine and exposure has to be from ziphy sternum till the pubic symphysis. And leg must be folded, okay, so that the abdominal wall remains, you know, relaxed. Now you have to follow all the rules of the percussion, like you have to move you have to do movement at the wrist joint and with the plexar. Plexar is the middle finger of the right hand, and plexometer is the middle finger of the left hand. Now I will start percussion from the midline and I will come to the lateral side. So I'll keep my fingers parallel to the longitudinal axis of the body and I will start percussion. Okay, here I found the tympanic node, which is the normal node over the abdomen, and then I moved laterally from midline to lateral. So tympanic node was heard from midline to the lateral. Suppose if the person has some amount of the ascitic fluid in the peritoneal cavity, I will start getting dull note here. So suppose if I am getting dull note here, I will stop at this point. I will keep my middle finger stick to this point and I will ask my subject to turn to the opposite side. Santoshi us taraf mud jayega. Okay, I'll ask my subject to turn to the opposite side and I will wait for 15 seconds. I'll wait for at least 15 seconds and then I will start percuss on the same point. And suppose I'm getting tympanic note again. So here in the beginning when I started getting dull note, after 15 seconds of the turning, suppose I am getting the tympanic note again, it means the shifting dullness test is positive. Why? Because in the beginning there was some fluid in the peritoneal cavity, so because of that I was getting dull note. But now when the patient is turned to the opposite side again, because now fluid is not there, so again I started getting tympanic node, because now there is viscera, there is hollow viscera, because of which I am getting tympanic node. So this is shifting dullness. The same thing I will repeat on opposite side. फिर से सीधा लेट जाइए. Again, I will start from the midline and I will go to the opposite side. Still tympanic node, tympanic node, tympanic node. Suppose I am getting dull note here. Okay, suppose in left flank I am getting dull node, I will ask my subject to turn to the अब इस तरफ मुड़ जाइए. Okay, I will wait for 15 seconds. Okay, and after 15 seconds I will percuss the same area where I started getting the dull node. So suppose I am getting the tympanic node again. So in the beginning there was dull node, but then there is tympanic node because of hollow viscera. There is because amount of the ascitic fluid is less and that travel to the opposite side, because that will remain on the dependent part. So here again I started getting the tympanic node. So this is called as shifting dullness test. So why it happened? It happened because there was some amount of the ascitic fluid which traveled to the dependent part of the body. So again the visceras, hollow visceras came up, because of which again I started getting the tympanic node. So this is called as shifting dullness test. So now the question is, how much amount of the fluid must be present for this test to become positive? So it is said that at least 500 ml of the ascitic fluid has to be present for this test to become positive. So this is about the shifting dullness test.